What's up, awesome YouTubers? Ryan1988 or Justin Becker do a video for you guys. And in this video, I'm here to do a movie update. I haven't done one of these in a very long time. I think the last one I did was back in Christmas, and that was kind of just showing you everything that I got on Christmas. But I haven't done like an actual movie update in a while. So I decided, why not show you guys some of my latest pickups. Now, I've gotten some other stuff, but this is stuff that I've recently gotten, and I wanted to show it off to you guys. Couple people sent me some things. I got a lot of great goodies, so I'll show those off and mention those. One thing I've already shown off, but I'm going to include it in this update. And then my buddy Resonantvania recently sent me a package. He's been one of my best bros and best friends for a long time. We started chatting on here in 2009, so, you know, I'm just grateful to have him in my life, and shout out to you, my brother, you rock, and I want to show your stuff off first, and then everything else, I'll talk about as I go along, but I got some really cool, horror movie releases, some other releases, some other non-horror releases that I want to talk off, and show you guys, talk about and show you guys, so, gonna get started with what my buddy Rez sent me. I'll talk about the movies in a minute. Some of the cool goodies that he sent me include this fantastic Funko Pop of Pepper from American Horror Story Freak Show, which I'm just starting to watch Freak Show. I loved Hotel. I was a big fan of that season. And I loved the first season, and I really enjoyed Coven. The only one I didn't really care for too much, and I guess I should finish it, is Asylum. But I'm really enjoying Freak Show so far, and I love Pepper, and I know she's from Asylum as well. But he sent that to me, and when I opened the box, my mouth dropped because I love that character, and I love this Funko Pop. I have some other Funko Pops. I have, you know, Jason and Freddy and Reagan and all those. They're in another room. And I don't have a lot of them. I have a good amount. But I'm only collecting ones that I really want. But this is amazing. And so I'm happy to have her. And I have some other characters from, Freak Show. You got Else Mars and Mia Petit. Then you got the Siamese twins, Pepper, and then Twisty. So, but yeah, still, that is fantastic. I love that. Love the character. And so that was amazing to get. And she is going to go right on my shelf back here, or she's going to go with the other ones. I haven't decided yet. I love this. So I don't know where I'm going to put her yet. But still, that is fantastic. He also sent me some miniature, I think these are mini Funko Pops. I'm recently getting into these, but he sent me Nosferatu, which was awesome. And then, what else? This is probably my favorite one, Alfred Hitchcock. And you can see he has the bird there. I love that one. That is killer. Awesome. The Vincent Price fly. Which I still haven't seen the movie, but I want to. But yeah, he sent me that one, which was really cool. Then he sent me Norman Reedus from The Walking Dead. Which was awesome. And then I'm pretty sure I know this character. I'm not 100% sure. But I think it's the character from Shaun of the Dead. If I'm correct. Which again is just awesome. These are really cool. He sent me some other ones a long time ago. Again, I have them in another room, but I love these, but that Pepper one, just love that, and the Hitchcock one. Those are probably my favorite ones, but all these are awesome. Thank you so much for those, my brother. He also sent me a lot of cool cards that include, you know, Walking Dead cards. And then I don't know too much about these characters. And I've never seen the movie. Kind of want to see it because it looks hilarious. But he sent me a lot of Garbage Pail Kid cards. If I said that correct. Garbage Pail Kids. So just a lot of them. He's Graffiti Petey. I just saw that one. Tasted Tony, which is really cool. So just a lot of these. Alarm Clark. So just pretty awesome. So these are cool to have. Large Marge. Just really awesome. So thank you so much, my brother, for sending these. Killer. I love it. And then on to the movies that he sent me. The first one I'll show you is one that I had on a single DVD, but I've always wanted to get this one again because I was a fan of it. I used to have a lot of fun with it. Very enjoyable. Great sci-fi flick. And it is Starship Troopers. And he sent me the 2-disc DVD because I believe he upgraded this on Blu-ray. And my single DVD never had any of the bonus features. So that's awesome to have. I've been meaning to check this one out again. So that is awesome. So thank you for that, brother. And then the last thing he sent me was something that I've wanted to see for a while because I heard him talk about it in his recent update. He loves it. And I know my friend Doug or Douglander grew up with this one. I had never heard of it until probably a few months ago. But I'm excited to see it. And it is Mosquito. And it's still in the shrink wrap. I haven't opened it yet. But I'm planning to watch this soon. This is something I've wanted to see. I believe the late Gunnar Hansen is in this movie. And I love that artwork. And I know there's reversible artwork because I saw it on Rez's update. But still, that is fantastic. Thank you so much, my brother, for that. I appreciate it a lot. I'm so excited to see this. And I think it's going to be one I'm going to watch tomorrow night. So I've been in, like, a, you know, kick of watching, like, some of my favorite horror movies again. And, like, really fun B-movies recently. And Mosquito is going to be a really fun B-movie. So I'm excited to see that. But, yeah, I had to show this stuff off real quick, and I want to give a shout-out to Resinovania, Rez, my brother. Like I said, I've known him since 2009, and, you know, I consider him one of my best friends, my best bro. We have a lot of great memories, and he's just awesome. So if you haven't subscribed to him yet, please go subscribe to him. I will leave a link down below. Check out his channel. He just makes fantastic videos, and he just started making videos again, so it's awesome. I love watching his updates, so I love watching any of his videos, but his updates are killer, so please go check him out. I will leave a link down below. If you don't know who he is yet, definitely go subscribe and watch his videos. So now on to some other things that I've gotten over time. The first thing I'll show is something that I've mentioned in one of my previous videos, and I showed it in detail, so I'm not going to really talk about it too much right now. But this was sent from my buddy Pat, and it is the Black Christmas exclusive Blu-ray, Season Greetings Blu-ray from Canada. And it's only available in Canada. I did a trade with him because I could not get it, and I traded him. He got a couple Blu-rays and a Funko Pop. And he sent this to me, so I was really stoked. This is something, I love this movie, big fan of this movie, but I'm also a big fan of this release. Watching the documentary and the bonus features, and the transfer is really good too. And it's definitely worth upgrading. So if you can get your hands on it, definitely do so. I'm so happy to have this. This is one of my favorite movies, one of my favorite horror movies. So I had to get that one. This is in my top 10 favorite horror movies. I love this movie. So Black Christmas, definitely had to get that one. And if you haven't seen my video and you want to see more detail, I'll leave that link down below as well. So going on, got some other cool things. I'll show these last because these are really awesome. Some non-horror releases. I just had to pick these up because these are some of my favorite movies. I love the original. I love the sequel. It's Mannequin 1 and Mannequin 2 on the move. Sorry about the glare. But yeah, had to pick these up. Olive Films released these. I just got these in the mail today, so I have not had a chance to watch these on Blu-ray. But these were my Valentine's gifts to me. I wanted to get myself a little something-something. So I got Mannequin and Mannequin 2. They're really cheesy, especially the sequel, but I grew up with these movies. I love them, and I had to get them. So I don't think they come with any bonus features, which, you know, the DVDs didn't either. But for me, just to have both of these on Blu-ray is fantastic. Bare bones. Well, I mean, there's, you know, some kind of cool artwork with them, but not too much. But there's that first one. And then you have the sequel. It's artwork there. So, but yeah, had to pick these up from Olive Films. I love these movies. Finally had to upgrade. If you're a fan, definitely go and pick them up. So, the next one I got, this is one of my favorite horror movies of last year, and one of my favorite comedies. It's a horror comedy. I love zombie movies, but there's some zombie movies nowadays that I'm not a fan of. But this one was just kind of fresh, and, you know, we've seen this type of zombie film before with, like, Shaun of the Dead and Dance of the Dead. You know, they're not full-on serious. There's a mix of comedy there. But I have to say, I like this better than those two movies. And it is Scout's Guide to the Zombie Apocalypse. I picked this up on Blu-ray last month or 2 months ago, whenever it came out last month. I had to get this one. I watched this movie before I bought it, and I loved it. Just a lot of fun, and I wanted to see this in theaters, missed out on it. So for me, when I saw that this was coming out, I had to pick it up, and just awesome. So Scout's Guide to the Zombie Apocalypse, a lot of fun. I love this movie, so that was a must for me. The next ones I got, and I left one out. Let's see if I can get it. Yes, I can. And I'm not editing this video, so yeah, you saw me reach for the movie. But picked up Crimson Peak. Had to show that off. It's a horror movie. But yeah, I picked that one up, and again, just one I love. And I saw this in theaters and I loved it, and I rewatched it and I loved it. And I know some people had problems with it. They said it was really slow, not scary. And, you know, it's not a straight up scary film, but I loved a lot of things about this. You know, the acting, the setting. I'm a big fan of Del Toro, so for me, this is one that I had to pick up, so Crimson Peak was a must, and I had to show this off. It was one of my favorites of last year, so I picked that up. And I got Spectre, the new Bond movie, right there, again, reaching for things. Picked that up, and again, one I loved. Just, you know, one that a lot of people kind of gave mixed reviews on, but for me, I loved it, and it's one of my favorite Bond movies, so Spectre. And I think this, and spoiler alert if you haven't seen it, but it's not really too much of a spoiler alert. The way this movie ends, which I'm not going to say, it might be Craig's last time as Bond. I don't know. It kind of gave that hint. I do hope he comes back because he's one of my favorites, but if he doesn't, he was one of the best Bonds. He is one of the best Bonds in my opinion, and I love this, so I was happy to get that. Very impressed with it. Missed it in theater, so I had to pick that one up on Blu-ray. Alright, now on to some of my favorite editions that I've recently picked up. The first three are from Arrow, and Arrow is finally releasing some really awesome releases here in the U.S. Society, I picked that one up a long time ago. I love that release. Love that movie. And then I had to get these. The first two I'm going to talk about are ones I've seen already. And I own them. One I own from a burned DVD. The other one I own the previous DVD release. But I had to pick up Eaten Alive. I love this movie. It's one of my favorite horror films. Like, you know, one of the first horror films I saw outside of the mainstream stuff. I remember renting this through the mail. I think it was Blockbuster at the time when they used to do that. And so I rented that and I fell in love with it the first time watch. And it's one of my favorite horror films. and one of my favorite Tobe Hooper films, so I had to pick that up. And then I'll show you real quickly what it looks like. It is a Blu-ray and DVD. So, and I watched the Blu-ray recently, and it looks fantastic on Blu-ray. And the bonus features were great, too. And if you had the Dark Sky 2-disc edition, this is a better transfer. That was really good. That transfer on that DVD was really good. But this is a better transfer. And also, if you love the bonus features on that, they're actually transferred over. So that's awesome as well. And then it does come with a really cool booklet. So, fantastic. But yeah, I had to pick that one up. And it's one of my favorite horror films. It has reversible artwork, which I'll show you real quick. Which I'm pretty sure you guys have seen this release on other YouTubers' videos. But there's the other artwork. I'm not a fan of the new artwork. I'm not too crazy about it, but I love that it came with the original poster artwork. So, I had to switch it. Awesome. The next one I picked up was one that I got about a week early before its release. And I was so happy with that. I ordered this, and I was just really happy that it came fast. And it's The Mutilator. And if you haven't ordered from familyvideo.com, fantastic place to buy movies. I buy a lot of my movies there. I work there. But I'm just saying, you know, a lot of their releases from that website, just amazing. And, you know, great shipping, great prices. I love a lot of the releases that I've ordered from there. And The Mutilator is one of my favorites. So I had to get that one, and that was just awesome. And I love this movie. I saw this movie back when I bought a burned DVD from a convention. Loved it then. It's really cheesy, pretty gruesome as well, especially when you watch it on, you know, Blu-ray. There's a lot more detail to it, so it's pretty gruesome. And it's the unrated cut, which I love. But I love this movie, like I said. Just a lot of fun. It's one of my favorite slashers, and I'm so happy that this finally got released on Blu-ray. So, pretty amazing. And then you have the original title and artwork, Fall Break, which for the longest time I thought this was another slasher movie, and then I found out it was just, you know, the same movie, just with a different title. So... And then, again, comes with a booklet. Booklet's really cool. But then you got the DVD, or the Blu-ray and DVD. So that's awesome. And again, reversible artwork, but it's just The Mutilator artwork. I just switched it because I like the Fall Break artwork as well. But, yeah, so I'm very, very impressed with this release. And... I've been really impressed with a lot of Era's releases. Their past stuff I loved, but I'm so happy and I'm a fan of their newest stuff, and I like the fact that they're releasing Region 1 releases now. So it comes with a really cool booklet, like a lot of the Era releases, and just happy to have this. One of my favorite releases to come out recently, and just really happy with that, so I picked that one up. Awesome. And then another Era release that I love, and I saw this movie for the first time about a month and a half ago or 2 months ago, and I loved it. I love this movie. You already saw the cover. Blood Rage, yes, had to get it. And I rewatched it again when I bought it, and just so much fun. If you love 80s slasher films, you like the cheesy ones, you'll love Blood Rage. It's one of the rare slashers that take place on Thanksgiving. And I love the title. It's not cranberry sauce, which is one of the taglines in the movie. The killer says it over and over. A lot of fun. This movie, it's not scary, but it's hilarious and very entertaining. There's a lot of cheesy dialogue in this movie. A lot of cheesy scenes and odd characters. But I love this. And if you've never heard of this movie, it's basically about... Well, it opens up at a drive-in, and there's these two twin brothers. They're about 10 years old, and their mom's making out with the guy in this car. So they get out of the car and they go explore, and they wind up finding an axe, or one of the twins finds an axe, and they spot this couple making out in the car. Well, the brother with the axe basically kills the guy in the car and then blames it on the innocent brother, and that innocent brother is sent to an asylum, and I think he's 25 years old in this movie. He escapes to kind of, you know, prove his innocence and prove that the brother who killed this person in the beginning of the movie is the one who did it. And that brother's been free this whole time, and it's just a really awesome movie. That's basically the premise of it, and it all takes place on Thanksgiving night. But I love Blood Rage. If you've never seen this movie, I highly recommend picking it up. I got this for $25, so it wasn't too bad for me. You know, Arrow's expensive, you know, they're pretty pricey, but every Arrow that I've gotten, especially their new ones, I've been highly impressed with them. And I love that artwork. That's the original artwork. So, and it's a 3-disc edition, so it's really cool. You get different cuts of the movies, lots of bonus features, and then there's other artwork back here. That is one of the newest artworks. It has the evil twin brother there. So, but yeah, if you've never seen Blood Rage and you love slasher movies, then definitely pick this one up. I highly recommend it. I was very impressed with a first-time release of this movie, because this movie's never had a DVD release, at least here in the U.S. And so it had a really awesome transfer and just a fantastic release. So I picked that one up. I love it. I highly recommend it. And then the last one I got was one that I got in the mail today, and I got this early, and I was really happy with it. I never expected to get this so quick. It only took 2 days, so it was pretty awesome. And it is Pieces. Awesome. Love this. Yeah, I had to get this one. This is one of my favorite slasher movies. It's really hokey and cheesy. But I rewatched this tonight, and I loved rewatching it, and to see it in HD is awesome. It looked really good, so, but yeah, Pieces. That's the new artwork, and I love that. Very cool. And then, let's see, hopefully there's no nudity on the back. There's not. But you got some images there, tons of bonus features, stuff that was transferred over from the previous Grindhouse release on DVD. And this is their Blu-ray, by the way, I forgot to mention it. But you got previous releases from that original out-of-print DVD, new bonus features, 4K transfer, which, like I said, highly impressed with the transfer, looked really good, so that was awesome. And then you got the outer box. It comes with the soundtrack, which I haven't listened to yet, but I love the music. And then I'm not going to open the inside because there's some nudity in there. I'm not going to do it. But it comes with a 2-disc edition. It's a, I believe it's just, I don't think it's a DVD copy. I think it's just a 2-disc Blu-ray copy. The first disc is the movie, and you get two versions. You get the unrated Spanish edition, and then you get the U.S. edition. And I watched the U.S. edition. I'll have to watch the Spanish edition, because it's unrated. But I watched the U.S. release when I first saw it, so I wanted to check out and see how good the transfer looked, and it looked really good. So I watched that version. I'll watch the other one later. What else? The second disc is all the bonus features, which I have not dug into those, but I've seen some of them from the previous release. And then, of course, I'm showing off the original artwork, which I love that artwork. Amazing. So, it was just awesome. And then on the inside, you get the puzzle from the movie, which I'm not going to show because there's nudity on it. And then you get a booklet, which I won't open because I think there's some graphic stuff on the inside. But anyway, this was just fantastic to get. Like I said, I'm a big fan of Pieces, and I love this movie. So, I had to get this, and very happy with it, so, Pieces. But anyway, guys, that is my update. I hope it wasn't too long for you. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was kind of everywhere. I had to grab stuff off the shelf, but I wanted to show some other things off. I've gotten some other stuff in the past that I haven't shown, but it would have been a lot of stuff. So I just wanted to show, you know, main stuff that I got from friends and that I've picked up over the last, I'd say this stuff is from at least the last 2 months, and had to show that off for you. Like I said, the pepper, I love that. Oh, awesome. Gotta put it in the back, right here. So, put it right there for right now. And then some other goodies my buddy Rez sent me. So, just fantastic. And of course the movies. And the cards. So, that was awesome. So, shout out to Resinovania, my brother Rez, you rock bro. Glad to see you back here on YouTube making updates. Loved your first one. Gonna watch the second part in a little while. And then to my buddy Pat, thank you once again for sending the Black Christmas Blu-ray. Fantastic. You rock. So anyway, guys, I'm gonna go. I hope you guys enjoyed my video this week. I will be back next week for another video. I don't know what it's gonna be yet. Maybe another movie update, maybe movie related, or another topical video. So I haven't really dug into other topics, so I might do that. But we'll see. I'll let you guys know, and you'll see that in my next video next week. So, as always, you guys are awesome. You guys rock. In with the positive, out with the negative. Tongue twister there. And go eat some Skittles, guys. I'll talk to you later. Bye.